Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, we're going to take a look at the new updates that are in 3.2, which LumaTouch just dropped the other day. And of course, the big news is there's new transitions. So let's take a look at them and the other features that you've now got available to you on LumaFusion. So this is the soft wipe up left. We then got the wipe up coming up. Then we move over to the soft wipe up right, and then wipe left, and then soft wipe spin, which is probably the most useful one. So we've got the soft wipe right, soft wipe down left, soft wipe down coming up, and then soft wipe down right. And these are nice and smooth. I really like these. After the soft wipes, we've got the shape wipe. Let's take a look at these. The inset wipe. And then we've got the circular version. Too hard an edge for me, but I could see it being useful. Curtain reveal. Vertical shutter, which I like. Then the blink version. Again, really nicely done. And then the mask. And that's all the shape wipes. We then go into the motion wipe. The fall, drop in, it's quite goofy, earthquake, clothesline effect, and then the spin, scale now, rotate, so there's the doorway, the hole, the black hole, you get spaghettified again. And then distortion, which I quite like. The next section in the transitions panel are the blurs. I'll look at these. Gaussian, then got the blur cut, the directional, which I quite like, the motion blur slide, and then the spin zoom. Now, when it comes to the spin zoom, what I would actually do is reduce its frames to around about 12 or 14 frames and then play it through, and as you can see, I think it works better, faster. The last four in the new collection are Bloom, which I kind of like. And then we've got the Long Flash, Black and White, which is quite nice. And then the Invert Shock, which again is one of these things that you want to make it as rapid as possible. Again, taking down to around about 14 frames. Yeah, to me that works better the faster it goes. And there you go. That's the new different transitions that they've added. Long awaited and much appreciated. One of the other new features is iCloud backups. So if you go into your files, go to LumaFusion, you will see project backups. Tap on that and you'll then see all the backups that have been put in place. Now these are just XML data backups. They're not actual media backups as well. You've still got to retain your media. It at least gives you the core part of your edit, which you can then find your media. The last new feature in 3.2 is the ability to rename files and linked folders. Now, this has its pros and cons, which I'm going to show you. I don't know if you've noticed, but throughout the transitions, I've got some of them actually marked with color. And this is basically just to sort of highlight them and make them more visible. So for example, we've got the mask here. I can go in, highlight transition, tap green, and give it a color, or I could make yellow, that kind of thing. Anything to sort of point out that I like to use this transition, and markup is a favorite effectively. What you can now do is you can tap on these little three dots at the top right corner and then rename clip, because it treats it like a clip. And then we can take away the numbering, and then all I do is put in a couple of hash symbols and then press enter, and that's now marked. And that means if we change the view type to the likes of this one, you can now see easily what's been marked off, or we can go back to this one, or we can do a hybrid. Now, as I already mentioned, there's pros and cons to renaming files and folders, and it's this. If, for example, I've got this shot of a man sandboarding, and I drag this down into the timeline, you can see it tells me it's 10 seconds, 11 frames, man sandboarding on the slope in a desert, 4K. But if I wanted to compress that to just sandboarding, obviously I can rename the clip, delete the current content, and just type in sandboarding. And we're done. Problem is though, it's renamed the clip up here in the cache media panel, but the original clip down here has still got the original name. So just be aware that if you're wanting to rename clips, it's probably best to do it prior to downloading onto the timeline and dragging and dropping. So you can now see it says sandboarding. So that's just, it's a little, you know, glitch something. I don't know whether they deliberately made it like that or it's just the way it works. I don't know. Just be aware that if you want to rename files, do it before you bring them into the timeline. Otherwise, you're going to have to rename them twice. And there you go. That's the three new updates for LumaFusion 3.2. If you've enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to the channel. There's loads of LumaFusion content. And of course, be notified of the next video tutorial. Ring that bell. I will catch you on the next one. See you later.